So field engineers at UNAVCO support researchers who work in a variety of different geology-related, science-related subfields. I do a lot of work in a shop, basically, building antenna mounts, building frames that will support large solar panels. We work with the PIs, that's the primary investigators on the projects, to figure out exactly how we should best design the experiment so that they can get the data that they need to be able to interpret the results in a meaningful way. Particularly in polar areas, one of the big questions right now is how much ice loss we're experiencing in places like Antarctica and Greenland. On the polar team, we split our time between working in the Antarctic and the Arctic. We spend a lot of time back here in the lab testing equipment, doing very strict quality control checks. We spend 10 and 20% of our time actually in the field supporting projects. Helheim Glacier is one of the two largest outlets of ice moving from the Greenland ice sheet down into the North Atlantic and Arctic Ocean. Massive calving events happen all through the summer on maybe once every 2 or 3 weeks. You know, normally when you imagine a glacier calving off into the ocean, it's just these like big chunks that are falling off. In this case, you know, the whole front edge of the glacier, which might be 6 kilometers wide, and a chunk that's half a kilometer thick will just break off and flip upside down. This is obviously very important for climate change to be able to monitor exactly how much ice they're losing from the Greenland ice sheet. So I was supporting a researcher who was trying to look at exactly how the glacier behaves up to these large calving events and during these large calving events. My role here was to come up with a style of GPS system that could survive the extremely harsh conditions on this glacier. I've actually found communication to be one of the most important skills in my repertoire. Just being able to talk to these researchers and develop a good rapport with them. I need to be able to help serve their project as best as possible. My undergraduate degree was in Earth and Ocean Sciences. When I was a junior, I had no idea what I wanted to do. So I just started asking my professors if they needed a research assistant. First one said no, second one said yes. So I ended up working for him for the first half of the summer building seismometers in his lab. And then the second half of the summer, he sent me to Iceland, which was an unbelievable experience and totally what sent me down this path. I kept on working for him through when I graduated and a little while after. And then I started a master's degree, which was actually in geochemistry. When I finished my master's, I applied for so many jobs and didn't even get a phone call back. So I actually ended up getting back in touch with that same professor who had given me a job my junior year. First said he didn't have anything available for me, and then a couple weeks later told me that that he needed a personal assistant. Within 6 months, I was working as a field engineer and worked my way up to project managing, doing seismic installations all over the world. I was doing that up until the point that I came to UNAVCO. It is a hard life traveling so much. You know, sometimes we travel, you know, for months at a time. For me, it's generally been up to about 20 to 25% of my year might be travel. It can be hard to develop relationships. It can be hard to keep friendships going. Any time you're following a career path that you think is your dream job, just remember that there's a reason that they're still paying you to do it, that there are some really fantastic parts, but then there are also some parts that are really not very fun. You know, there's a lot of time that you still spend behind a desk filling out expense reports. There are a lot of times that things just aren't going the way that you'd like them to go, and there can be some real challenges. But you know, it can still absolutely be worth it.